So looking forward to the film. I am a big fan of Jim Broadbent, and he's a friend, so it's great to be able to come and support and see his work.
What makes Jim such an extraordinary talent, do you think?
Sure, it is. I think there's a level of play that he has that I'm used to seeing on stage, people that are that kind of bold with their choices, and he manages to do that on screen without it seeming outlandish or over the top, but really just masterful. So yeah, always excited to watch and learn and enjoy.
Interstellar is an astonishing piece of cinema. Now that's actually out, we can talk to you a little bit more about it. I guess, can you just start by talking about the experience of working with Matthew? Because I think there's a sense that amongst all of his fantastic performances of recent years, this one is another memorable, potentially Oscar-winning performance.
Yeah, I know. And actually, it shouldn't have surprised me, really, but his work ethic is incredible. And I think quite often when people are sort of known for a certain genre, we kind of go, oh, that's what that person does. And we can neglect to see the skill and the talent and the craftsmanship that goes into that. So to be able to see that firsthand was an invaluable experience, actually. I really rate him. I think he's brilliant.
I mean, the film has such huge ideas behind it. I'm curious, has the process of making the film changed your perspective on what it means to be human and these kind of big issues?
It's certainly enhanced my perspective on what it means to be human. I'd be lying if I said it hasn't caused me to look at certain things. But I'm interested in the different dimensions that exist out there and how... I think there's a great line in it which talks about love and how... love could actually be something that's tangible, and I think Anne Hathaway's character says about how we manage to love people that are dead, but that doesn't change from the love that we have for them whilst they're here. It may grow or it may change shape, but the size of it doesn't change, and I think that's interesting to explore, and my mind's kind of thought about that a few times when I've sat down. Yeah.
How do you feel about the ending? I think some people were suggesting it was maybe a little too neat or it was a little too sentimental, but I think other people seem to think it fit just right.
Yeah, I think once you have that set up like that, you kind of have to go through with it, you know? And if you're talking about relativity and different time zones, then you have to kind of complete that. So I'm very happy of the boldness, the bold decision that was taken.